Dear student, let us learn about the stigmata of chronic liver disease. You know, stigmata are the clinical signs which we can see from the outside. And after observing that stigmata, we can assume or we can guess that our patient might be suffering from the certain disease. So today in this YouTube channel, Medicine Classroom, I am going to teach you about the stigmata of chronic liver disease. The first stigmata of chronic liver disease is jaundice. And you know why there is a jaundice. As there is a liver dysfunction, there is elevation of both conjugated and unconjugated bilirubin in the circulation, and that is the mechanism of jaundice in a patient with CLD. Another stigmata of chronic liver disease is parotid enlargement, and you will see that when there is the lifting of the ear lobule by the parotid swelling, and sometimes you can even see the obliteration of the retroauricular sulcus. The mechanism of parotid enlargement in a patient with CLD is due to the fatty infiltration of the parotid gland. It was a proposed theory, and another mechanism is because of the autonomic dysfunction, which leads to the viscid parotid secretion and block the parotid duct. These are the proposed mechanism, and when you are looking after the patient with CLD, we have to look at the parotid enlargement as well. So another stigmata of chronic liver disease is spider nevi, which is also called the spider angioma. You will see there is a dilatation of the arteriole along the territory of superior vena cava, and the test that we do to detect the spider nevi is other than the inspection is the dioscopy, where you can press this arteriole by the glass slides, and there will be blanching of this arteriole. Once you release that glass slide, then there will be again refilling of this arteriole. So CLD is one of the cause of spider angioma, and other causes are like a patient who is using the estrogen, especially OCP pills, or pregnant lady. Sometimes in thyrotoxicosis, you can see the spider angioma. And like what disease of the spider angioma are like the, it may be because of insect bite or Campbell D. Morgan spot, and you have to differentiate the spider angioma from those conditions. Near about 40 to 45% of the cirrhosis people, you will see the spider angioma in the upper chest. So as a medicos, we should never forget to check the spider angioma and in a patient with CLD. Another stigmata of chronic liver disease is gynecomastia. Usually you see in case of male patient, there is an enlargement of glandular part of the breast. If there is a enlargement of the fatty part, then that is called lipomastia, that is not a gynecomastia, and that's usually a physiological. So in a patient with chronic liver disease, because of the increased level of estrogen, there is increased level of estrogen in a patient with CLD due to the impaired clearance of androstenedione in the liver, you will see the there will be elevation in the estrogen, and that caused the gynecomastia in a patient with CLD. And to say whether there is a gynecomastia or not, you have to palpate the glandular part and measure the diameter of the glandular part. And if it is more than 5 cm, then we can say that there is a gynecomastia. So there are so many causes of gynecomastia, but one of the causes is definitely cirrhosis. Another stigmata is loss of axillary hair, and the mechanism of loss of axillary hair is because of the increased level of the estrogen in the circulation in a patient of chronic liver disease. So please do not forget to check the axilla, because it is one of the stigmata of chronic liver disease. After examining the axilla, we have to examine the skin over the hand, and usually there is a paper money skin. It's because of the low albumin in a patient with cirrhosis, and it is one of the stigmata of chronic liver disease. Please comment upon the skin in a patient with CLD. Another stigmata is palmar erythema, where you can see there is erythema in the palm and sparing the central part of the palm. Sometimes you can even see the mottled patch in the palm, red color mottled patch in the palm. The reason for the palmar edema is his increased level of estrogen in a patient with CLD. And other cause of palmar edema is, you can see the palmar edema in a patient with polycythemia vera, or sometimes in a patient who has carbon dioxide retention, like in a patient with COPD. So please check the palmar edema. So here I am demonstrating you the dupuytren contractures, where there's a contracture of the ring finger. It's because of the fibrosis of the palmar fascia, and like the proposed mechanism is because of the fatty infiltration of the palmar fascia in a patient with alcoholic liver disease. And the cause of dupuytren contractions are the usual cause are trauma, like past history of trauma, or the occupation like mechanic hand. These are the cause, but these dupuytren contractions is definitely one peripheral stigmata of chronic liver disease that we have to comment upon. Another peripheral stigmata of chronic liver disease is flapping tremor or asterexis. We have to always examine the asterexis by extending the wrist and supporting the forearm from the below. And this is the type of negative myoclonus where there is a lapse of this position. Okay, and the mechanism of this flapping tremor is impairment of the inflow from the joint of the wrist to the reticular activating system in brain stem, and this occurs because of the increased level of the ammonia in the brain. So we should always check, because when there is asterexis, then we have to suspect the aortic encephalopathy, one of the important and the deadly complication of the chronic liver disease. So student, please check the asterexis or asterexis. The other cause of asterexis are like the when there is uremic encephalopathy or CO2 narcosis, you can see the asterexis. Okay. Another stigmata of chronic liver disease is the signs of portal hypertension, like caput medesi. You can see here there is a dilated veins in and around the umbilicus. It's because of the portal hypertension. Another is ascites. You can see the distended abdomen over here. But other examination that you have to do to elicit the ascites is you can do the portal sign, you can do the shifting dullness, and you can do the fluid thrill. And in inspection, you can just observe whether there is a flank fullness or not. But the caput medesi and ascites is one of the important stigmata of the chronic liver disease that we have to comment upon. Another stigmata of chronic liver disease is testicular atrophy. So we should never forget to check the testes if you are suspecting the chronic liver disease. And ideally, we have to compare the testis size with the orchidometer. Okay, but it may or may not be available to you people, but you have to check the whether there is a presence or absence of testicular atrophy in a patient with chronic liver disease. So I think you people have understood the different types of stigmata, its mechanism, and how we are supposed to examine the stigmata of chronic liver disease. If you have any comment, then you can write in a comment section. Till now, bye-bye. Enjoy learning and have fun on learning the medicine. Thank you so much.